A Czech anti-dope university in Dakar in the physics department laboratory, Ndiaye Martin Ndiaye is working on a project that could revolutionize access to energy in rural areas. Using organic materials such as peanut shells, hibiscus or bamboo, the postdoctoral fellow is developing batteries.
Usually for this type of application, people only use chemicals. What is new is the use of 100% biomass. Another thing is that we use what people usually throw in the street.
It's clean and cheap energy that's intended to reduce the use of fossil fuels. The project was initiated by Professor Bala Diop Ngom in 2014 when Day was one of his students. She devoted her master's and her thesis to the subject.
She's the right hand of this project. She's the one who is really there, active. She's a trustworthy person. She's a reactive person. Science has no time. It's all about reaction. So it's important to have these kinds of people around you.
The 38-year-old Ndiaye is now a teacher and a researcher, and this year she has split her time between Dakar and Philadelphia in the United States, where she obtained a scholarship. She hopes to become a model for her students in order to trigger their interest.
In Senegal, women scientists, the percentage is low. It is important for us to carry this work to motivate other young women to join us to work together. We are going to change Senegal, Africa, and why not the world?
And her fight seems to bear fruit, especially in this laboratory, which accommodates a majority of women, a rarity on the continent.
It's very rare to see a married woman who continues to do research in this area. There aren't so many of them. They are very rare, found especially here in Africa, because here we consider that the place of women is behind a stove. This motivates us. She's an example to all of us here.
Displaying her generosity, Day has decided to devote her endowment to the purchase of equipment for her laboratory.